إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد. The topic inshallah ta'ala today I will speak about is the grave. My beloved brothers and sisters, the grave is the first station from the stations of the hereafter. Abdullah ibn Bahira, Abdullah ibn Bahir, he said that he heard Hani, who was the Mawla of Uthman. Hani was a slave boy for Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So he heard Abdullah ibn Bahiri said, I heard Hani saying that Uthman ibn Affan was a person, إِذَا وَقَفَ عَلَىٰ قَبْرٍ بَكَىٰ. Uthman was a person that if he stood over a grave, he would cry, حَتَّى يَبُلَّ لِحْيَتَهُ. He would cry excessively and so much that his beard would be filled with tears. His beard would soak. فقيل له, it was then said to Uthman, تذكر الجنة والنار فلا تبكي. The Jannah is spoken about, the Nar is spoken about, and you don't cry. And then when you come to this place, وتبكي من هذا, and you cry from the grave, and when you see the grave, you cry. فقال, he said, إن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إن القبر أول منازل الآخرة. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said that the grave is the first station of the hereafter. فإن نجا منه, if the person makes it through the grave, فما بعده أيسر منه, everything else after that is easy and simple. وإن لم ينجو منه, if the person doesn't make it in the grave, فما بعده أشد منه, everything after that is going to be hard for them. And this is why Uthman used to cry a lot. And then Uthman went on to saying that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, مَا رَأَيْتُ مَنْظَرًا قَطَّ. Uthman said that the Prophet said, I have never seen a sight more devastating. مَا رَأَيْتُ مَنْظَرًا قَطُّ إِلَّا وَالْقَبْرُ أَفْضَعُ مِنْهُ. Except that the grave was more devastating than it. The Prophet is saying, I never saw a sight more devastating, more terrorizing, more scarier than the grave. And Imam Tirmidhi narrated this. So the grave is the first station, my beloved brothers and sisters. If you make it through the grave, if you answer the questions, if you pass the test, then everything after that is a path of success. You've made it. And if you fail in the grave, then you're truly going to fail every stage after. Al-Imam Hassan al-Basri rahimahullah, he said something very powerful. He said, يَوْمَانِ وَلَيْلَتَانِ, 2 days and 2 nights, لَمْ تَسْمَعِ الْخَلَائِقُ بِمِثْرِهِنَّ قَطْ. The humans have never seen the likes of these 2 days, and they've also not seen the likes of these 2 nights. These 2 days and these 2 nights, humans have never seen the likes of it. So what are they? Laylatun tabitu ma'a ahli al-qubur, the night that you spend with the people of the grave. This night, you've never seen a night like this before. For the first time, you're spending your first night in the grave. Walam tabit laylatun qablaha, you've never slept a sleep like this before. Or you've never been in a place like this before. وَلَيْلَةٌ, the second night is, وَلَيْلَةٌ صَبِيحَتُهَا يَوْمُ الْقِيَامَةِ, the night which its morning is going to be the day of judgment. Tomorrow for the first time, you're going to encounter the day that has been promised. That night before the day of judgment, there is no night like that. It's your final day in your grave. Either the good that you have put forward is waiting for you, or the evil that you've done is waiting for you on the other side. Reality has started for you. As for the 2 days, is وَيَوْمَ يَأْتِيكَ الْبَشِيرُ مِنَ اللَّهِ, the day when the news comes to you from Allah. إِمَّا بِالْجَنَّةِ وَإِمَّا بِالنَّارِ, either to Jannah or to Nar. One of the two, news is going to come to you and say to you, you're either from the inhabitants of Jannah or you're from the inhabitants of the hellfire. That day, there's no day like it. When you find out where you're going to be, either you're going to be excessively happy, and no day has ever come like this. Or that day, as Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha said, if anybody would have died due to the depression that they endure, then it would be those people that day. As for the second day, is وَيَوْمَ تُعْطَى كِتَابَكَ, the day when your book is going to be given to you. إِمَّا بِيَمِينِكَ, either in your right, وَإِمَّا بِشِمَالِكَ, or in your left. That day when the book is given to you, your book of record, your deeds are in it, and it's being passed over to you. You're either going to take it with your right or your left. That day, there's no day like it. يَوْمَانِ وَلَيْلَتَانِ, 2 days and 2 nights, humans have never seen or heard of the likes of this. My beloved brothers and sisters, Al-Bara ibn Azim radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, بَيْنَمَا نَحْنُ مَعَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ, one day we were with the messenger, Nabiullah Muhammad, the Prophet of Allah, we were with him. And as we were with him, إِذْ بَصُرَ بِجَمَاعَ, the Prophet, he saw a group of people gathered somewhere. Nabiullah Muhammad, he saw a group of people that came together and they were gathered. إِذْ بَصُرَ بِجَمَاعَةٍ فَقَالَ, the Prophet then said, عَلَى مَجْتَمَعَ عَلَيْهِ هَؤُلَاء, the Prophet said, why have these people come together? What has brought these people together? Nabiullah Muhammad asked the companions, he said, why are these people standing there? What is their reason? What's their story? They said to the Prophet, عَلَى قَبْرٍ يَحْفِرُونَهُ, O Messenger of Allah, they are digging a grave. فَفَزِعَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ, the Messenger became scared and he became stressed. فَبَدَرَ بَيْنَ يَدَيْ أَصْحَابِهِ مُسْرِعًا, then the Messenger started to run. He ran away from his companions and he ran towards the gathering, the place where the people were standing. Nabiullah Muhammad charged towards that direction. حَتَّى انْتَهَى إِلَى الْقَبْرِ, the Messenger came to the edge of the grave and he stood over it. فَجَثَى عَلَيْهِ, then he fell on his knees. عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ. فَاسْتَقْبَلْتُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ, Al-Bara ibn Azib, he said, I came from the front direction. I came from the front, wanting to see what the Prophet is doing right now. When he ran, I ran with him. When he went on his knees, I went right in front of him. I wanted to see the Prophet and how he is, and what is he going to do, and what is he going to say. فَاسْتَقْبَلْتُ مِنْ بَيْنِ يَدَيْهِ لِأَنْظُرَ مَا يَصْنَعُ, so I can look at what he's going to do. فَبَكَى, the Prophet cried. حَتَّى بَلَّ الثَّرَى مِنْ دُمُوعِهِ, until the tears that came out the Prophet's eyes, it filled the earth. The tears fell so much from the Prophet's eyes, عليه الصلاة والسلام, and it rolled from his face, and it rolled from his beard, that it filled the portion in front of him, عليه الصلاة والسلام, from the earth. And then the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he turned towards the companions. ثُمَّ أَقْبَلَ عَلَيْنَا, the Prophet turned towards the companions. فَقَالَ, he said to them, إِخْوَانِي, my brothers, لِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْيَوْمِ فَأَعِدُّوهُ, the likes of this day, prepare for it. He turned towards the companions and he looked at them and he said to them, لِمِثْلِ هَذَا الْيَوْمِ, the likes of this day, فَأَعِدُّوهُ, prepare for it. Stack righteous deeds, put effort forward. رواه أحمد في مسنده, and Imam Ahmad narrated this in his Musnad. My beloved brothers and sisters, do not let it deceive you, the way that the graves look like from the top surface. Yes, from the surface they look the same. You don't know what's happening underneath. A group of people are in حُفْرَةٌ مِنْ حُفَرِ النَّارِ. They are in a pit from the pits of the hellfire. And another group of people are in رَوْضَةٌ مِنْ رِيَاضِ الْجَنَّةِ. They are in the gardens from the gardens of Jannah. Don't let it deceive you from how it looks from the top. Ibn Sammak rahimahullah, he said, لَا يَغُرَّنَّكَ. Do not let it deceive you. سُكُوتُ هَذِهِ الْقُبُورِ. The tranquility, the calmness of the graves from the top. فَمَا أَكْثَرَ الْمَغْمُومِينَ فِيهَا. So much people are deceived by what they see from the top surface. وَلَا يَغُرَّنَّكَ. And do not let it deceive you. إِسْتِوَاءُهَا. How level the graves are. فَمَا أَشَدَّ تَفَاوُتَهُمْ. Because those who are living underneath, they are not leveled. Some people are high up in paradise. They are in Jannatul Firdaus. And another people are in Hawiya. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا هِيَ. Some people are in the hellfire, burning ashes. Do not let it deceive you for how it looks from the top surface. Brothers and sisters, if you don't put in hard work and you don't prepare for that day, then when your body is taken and you die, you're not going to look forward for what's waiting for you in your grave. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us a hadith of Imam al-Tirmidhi narrated in his Sunan, hadith of Abu Huraira. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, that the Messenger said, إذا قبر الميت, when the dead body is placed in the grave, أو قال أحدكم, or one of you, أتاه ملكان أسودان أزرقان, when the person is placed in his grave, two black angels will come to him. Those angels, they have blue eyes. يقال لأحدهما, one of those angels is called المنكر, that's the name of the angel. وللآخر, and the second one is called النكير. فيقولان, the two angels will say, they will say to the person in the grave, ما كنت تقول في هذا الرجل. What is it that you used to say about Nabiullah Muhammad? What was your stance regarding him? Did you follow his path? Do you know who he was? The person who was righteous, the noble person, the person who lived by the religion of Allah, who took Nabiullah Muhammad as their role model, their response will be, فَيَقُولُ مَا كَانَ يَقُولُ. He will say that which he used to say in the earth. He will say, هُوَ عَبْدُ اللَّهِ. Nabiullah Muhammad is a slave of Allah. وَرَسُولُهُ. He is a messenger sent from Allah. أَشْهَدُ. I testify. أَلَّا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. That there is none worthy of worship except Allah. وَأَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا. And that Muhammad is عَبْدُهُ. His slave. وَرَسُولُهُ. And his messenger. فَيَقُولَانِ. The two angels will say to him, قَدْ كُنَّا نَعْلَمُ. We knew that you were going to say this. قَدْ كُنَّا نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ تَقُولُ هَذَا. We knew that this was the response that you were going to give. How did they know that he was going to say that? Because they knew he lived by the religion of Allah. He stood by the deen. His rules and regulations, he took it from the Quran and the Sunnah. If Allah told him to do something, he hastened to doing it. If Allah told him to stay away from something, he stayed away from it. So the angels knew that this person was prepared and he was ready. قَدْ كُنَّا نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ تَقُولُ هَذَا. We knew that you were going to say this. ثُمَّ يُفْسَحُ لَهُ فِي قَبْرِهِ سَبْعُونَ ذِرَاعًا. Then the person's grave is going to be widened for them, 70 arms span. ثُمَّ يُنَوَّرُ لَهُ فِيهِ. And then the grave will be illuminated for him. It will glow. ثُمَّ يُقَالُ لَهُ. And then it will be said to him, نَمْ. Go to sleep. فَيَقُولُ. He will say, أَرْجِعُ إِلَىٰ أَهْلِي. I want to go back to my family. فَأُخْبِرُهُمْ. I want to inform them that I passed the test, that I made it to Jannah, that I succeeded. I want to tell them that my grave has been widened for me. And they will say to him, نَمْ. Sleep. كَنَوْمَةِ الْعَرُوسِ. Like the sleeping of a newlywed. الَّذِي لَا يُوقِذُهُ إِلَّا أَحَبُّ أَهْلِيهِ إِلَيْهِ. Which no one wakes him up except the most beloved person to him in his family member. حَتَّى يَبْعَثَهُ اللَّهُ. Until Allah resurrects that person, he will be enjoying in that grave. It will be shining for him. He will be enjoying himself. حتى يبعثه الله, until Allah brings him out من مضجعه ذلك, from that place which he's lying in. وإن كان منافقا, if the person was a hypocrite, he pretended he was a Muslim, but in his heart there was something different. He did not live by Allah's religion. He picked and chose what he wanted to take. وإن كان منافقا, if he was a hypocrite, قال, that he would say, when they ask him about Nabi Allah Muhammad, his response is going to be, سَمِعْتُ النَّاسَ يَقُولُونَ, I heard the people say something, فَقُلْتُ مِثْلَهُ, and I said what they said, لَا أَدْرِي, but I don't know who he is. فَيَقُولَانِ, the angels would then say to him, قَدْ كُنَّا نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ تَقُولُ ذَلِكَ, we knew you were going to say that. How do they know that he was going to say that? Because they knew his dealings, his way of life in this dunya and how he was. They were fully aware of it. They were the ones who were writing his deeds, his actions. They were the ones who were writing it. So they said to him, قَدْ كُنَّا نَعْلَمُ أَنَّكَ تَقُولُ ذَلِكَ, we knew that you were going to say this. We knew you won't be able to answer the question. فَيُقَالُ لِلْأَرْضِ, then the angels will speak to the earth. And they will say to the earth, إِلْتَئِلِي عَلَيْهِ, come together, squeeze this individual. فَتَلْتَئِمُ عَلَيْهِ, then the walls of the graves will come together. فَتَخْتَلِفُ فِيهَا أَضْلَاعُ, and then his ribs will surpass and cross through each other. فَلَا يَزَالُ فِيهَا مُعَذَّبًا, the person will be punished and he will go through torment. حَتَّى يَبْعَثَهُ اللَّهُ, until Allah resurrects him, مِنْ مَضْجِعِهِ ذَلِكَ, until Allah resurrects him from the place which he is lying in. رواه الترمذي, الإمام الترمذي narrated this. أبي سعيد الخدري narrated that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said that كان النبي, the Prophet of Allah, he was one who used to say, إذا وضعت الجنازة, if the body, the dead body is placed on the shoulders, and the people, they pick up the dead body. فاحتملها الرجال, the person is dead, the people, they pick him up from the leg, and they pick him up from the upper body, and they place him on their shoulders. فاحتملها الرجال على أعناقهم, فإن كانت صالحة, if this person was righteous, he lived by the religion of Allah, قلبا وقالبا, externally and internally, he lived by the deen of Allah, his response is going to be, قدموني, take me quickly to my grave. Why are you spending too much time keeping me in this dunya? Take me to my grave quickly. وإن كانت غير صالحة, if the person is not righteous, he's a devilish criminal, he will say, قالت لأهلها, he will say to the people who are carrying it, who want to take it to the grave, he will say to them, يَا وَيْلَهَا, destruction be to my people. أَيْنَ يَذْهَبُونَ بِهَا, where are they taking my body? يَسْمَعُ صَوْتَهَا كُلُّ شَيْءٍ, everybody will hear the screaming, the shouting and the fighting that this dead body will put through, and that he will go through, and that which he would say. وَلَوْ سَمِعَ الْإِنسَانُ لَصَعِقْ, but the humans won't hear it. And if the humans were to hear the way that this person screams and he shouts, then they would faint. رواه البخاري, and Imam al-Bukhari narrated it. My beloved brothers and sisters, when you are put in your grave, in the morning and in the evening, you are shown your place in Jannah, or you're shown your place in the hellfire. Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ أَحَدَكُمْ, that one of you, إِذَا مَاتَ, if he dies, عُرِضَ عَلَيْهِ مَقْعَدُهُ بِالْغَدَاتِ وَالْعَشِيِّ, if one of you dies, his place in Jannah or his place in the hellfire will be presented to him, it will be shown to him. إِنْ كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ, if the person is from the people of Jannah, فَمِنْ أَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ, then he's from the people of Jannah, he will be shown Jannah. وَإِنْ كَانَ مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ, if the person is from the people of the hellfire, فَمِنْ أَهْلِ النَّارِ, then he will be shown the hellfire. فَيُقَالُ, it will be said to him, هَذَا مَقْعَدُكَ, this is your place. حتى يبعثك الله حتى يبعثك الله يوم حتى يبعثك الله يوم القيامة. Until Allah resurrects you the day of judgment, He will be shown His place in the grave, and it will be said to Him, this is your place in Jannah. Or if He's from the people of the hellfire, it will be said to Him, this is your place in the hellfire. Everybody hears the punishment of the person who's been punished in the grave. Abi Sa'id al-Khudri, he said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was one day, بينما النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet one day, he was with his companions, في حائط لبني النجار, the Prophet was in a garden owned by the people of Bani Najjar, على بغلة له, the Prophet was on a mule, a riding beast, he was mounted on a mule of his, عليه الصلاة والسلام, على بغلة له, ونحن معه, the companions were with him. The Prophet was on his riding beast. It hadat bihi, the riding beast, it diverted from the path and it went towards a particular road. It diverted from the path. فَكَادَتْ تُلْقِيهِ, the riding beast was about to throw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam off its back, the way it ran very fast. فَكَادَتْ تُلْقِيهِ وَإِذَا أَقْبُرُ سِتَّةٌ أَوْ خَمْسَةٌ أَوْ أَرْبَعَةٌ. The riding beast went fast. The messenger was on it. He was about to fall off it. So he grabbed himself. And the Prophet looked around and he saw the narrator. He didn't know the amount of graves there were. So he said either 6 or 5 or 4. Then the messenger said, عليه الصلاة والسلام, من يعرف أصحاب هذه الأقبور? Who knows the people of this grave? Does anyone know their story? فقال رجل, a man said, أنا, O Messenger of Allah, I know who these people are. The Prophet, he said, who are these people? When did they die? What's their story? And then he said to him, ماتوا على الإشراك. These people, they died upon disbelief. They died upon shirk. فقال رجل, then the messenger said, فقال رسول الله, the messenger said, إن هذه الأمة, this أمة, تبتلى في قبورها, this أمة are going to be tested in their grave. فلولا ألا تدافنوا, if it wasn't that you guys would not bury your dead, لسألت الله أما لدعوت الله, I would have asked Allah, أن يسمعكم من عذاب القبر, that Allah allows you to hear the punishment that's taken in the grave. If it wasn't for fear that you would not bury your dead, I would have asked Allah that He allows you to see, or to hear, sorry, the punishment that's taking the place in the grave. Then the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, he turned towards his companions and then he said to them, تعوذوا بالله من عذاب القبر. قالوا نعوذ بالله من عذاب القبر. The Prophet said, seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave. And the companions, they said, we seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the hellfire, sorry. Then the messenger said, تعوذوا بالله من عذاب القبر. Then seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave. Then the companions, they said, نعوذ بالله من عذاب القبر. We seek refuge in Allah from the punishment of the grave. Then the Prophet said, تعوذوا بالله من الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. Seek refuge in Allah from the trials and tribulation, that which is apparent and that which is hidden. Then the companions, they said, نعوذ بالله, we seek refuge in Allah, من الفتن, the trials and tribulation, ما ظهر منها, that which is apparent, وما بطن, and that which is hidden. Then the messenger said, تعوذوا بالله من فتنة الدجال. Seek refuge in Allah from the trials of the Antichrist. قالوا, the companions, they said, نعوذ بالله, we seek refuge in Allah من فتنة الدجال. رواه مسلم, الإمام المسلم narrated this. عائشة رضي الله تعالى عنها, she said, دخلت علي عجوزان من عجوز يهود المدينة. عائشة said, one day two elderly women from the Jews came to me. ف فقالتا لي, both of them said to me, إن أهل القبور, the people of the graves, يعذبون في قبورهم. These two old Jewish women, they said to Aisha that the people are punishing their graves. Aisha then said, فكذبتهما, I disbelieved in their statement. I didn't take what they said serious. ولم أنعم أن أصدقهما. And he said, I didn't take it upon myself to believe in what they were saying. فخرجتا, both of them, they left. ودخل علي النبي. Then the messenger came in. فقلت له, I said to him, يا رسول الله, O messenger of Allah, إن عجوزين, وذكرت له. Two elderly women, and I told the Prophet the story, what they said to me. فقال, the Prophet said to me, صدقتا, both of them, they told you the truth. إنهم يعذبون عذابا, the people are punished, a punishment, تسمعه البهائم, the cattle and the animals will hear it, كلها, all of them. Aisha then said, فما رأيته, I never saw the Prophet after that day, بعد في صلاة, in a prayer, إلا تعوذ من العذاب القبر, except that he sought from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala refuge from the punishment of the grave. رواه البخاري. الإمام البخاري narrated this. My beloved brothers and sisters, لمثل هذا اليوم فأعدوه, the likes of this day, and prepare for it, work for it. The people are only one of two. Either they are فريقٌ في الجنة, or they are فريقٌ في السعير. They are either the people of Jannah, or they are from the people of the hellfire. Anything which I have said that was wrong, any mistakes, any errors, any faults, any shortcomings, is from me, Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.